they are species from soil. They can penetrate the roots of plants. They can reduce abiotic stress. It is one of 1.5 million species on Earth. However, what can Arbuscular mycorrhizal fungi contribute in biotechnology of agriculture field? What people interest in doing research in this topic? What people are trying to discover? What they already done with this biotechnology? And what are they trying to do for the ultimate goal in the future of agriculture? Arbuscular mycorrhizal fungi, also known as AMF, is a fungi species from soil. It can help in reducing abiotic stress and obtain a better yield and promote growth of plant. AMF belongs to subphylum of Glomicromycotina of the phylum Mucoromycota. Mycorrhizae is a biotrop and it can take in lipids and carbon compounds for digestion for supporting its life cycle. AMF is an alternative for plants to survive during drought stress and it can protect hosts against pathogens. AMF also can act as one of the bio ingredients in biofertilizer and it can enhance the productivity even under drought stress. So AMF can sustain system of energy and food source for human in Earth. Nowadays, we are suffering with a problem climate change which is causing drought in large areas of the Earth. Drought is one of the most destructive abiotic stress being faced by plants and it has widely attracted the attention of agriculture scientists and biotechnologists. Drought is a major concern agriculture problem and reduce or limits plant growth and productivity. A large piece of agriculture land is affected by drought and it adversely affects human society, economical rate, etc. Drought stress limits water content available in soil, reduce cell size, membrane integrity, produce reactive oxygen species, and promotes leaf senescence, causing reduction in crop productivity. Apart from morphological change, there are some molecular change in drought stress plants, such as increase in ethylene production, which is stress responsive phytohormone, reduction in chlorophyll content, and inhibition in photosynthetic rate. Drought elevates accumulation of free radical that induce change in membrane function, protein conformation, and lipid peroxidation, leading to cell death. It is being believed by some scientists that we will increase in drought as time pass out due to climate change. Drought stress is among the most destructive abiotic stress that increase in intensity over the past decades, affecting world's food security. Drought stress may range from moderate and short to extremely severe and prolonged duration, restricting the crop yields. Drought is expected to cause serious plant growth problem for more than 50% of the arable lands by 2050. Under drought stress, plants adapt themselves through physiological, biochemical, and molecular response and control water status by adjustment of root hydraulic conduction, reduced transpiration, and stomata closure. A change in plant stress responsive genes is found by transcriptomic and proteomic approach. Some genes found unpre-regulate, whereas other are found down-regulate. In molecular response of drought, plants synthesize some specific proteins to impart drought tolerance, such as LEA, late embryogenesis abundant, deficient stress protein, and dehydrin. In addition, mycorrhizal association is a symbiotic, non-pathogenic relationship between plant roots and fungal hyphae. In this mutuality association, the fungi gain carbon compounds and other nutritional supplements for the roots of plants, and in return provide the plant with macro and micro such as nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium, calcium, copper, and zinc from the soil. The importance of mycorrhizae association in both agriculture and ecological system had earlier been widely recognized. The increased plant growth by vesicular arbuscular mycorrhizae association is usually due to increased mineral elements uptake by the hyphae from the soil, improve water retention and pest resistance of houseplant. VAM produce tolerance to a variety of abiotic stress and increase resistance to soil pathogens. Mycorrhizae can also resist drought in many plants under stress condition. Therefore, the plants infected with VAM are less likely to wilt under drought affected condition as compared to non-inoculated plants. Biofertilizer are alternative fertilizer which can enhance the plant productivity without harming the environment. So, AMF is used as biofertilizer to replace inorganic fertilizer to cut the usage of chemical fertilizer above 50%. This alternative can measure the ecological imbalance to plants, soil, and human health, besides avoiding plants from biotic stress and abiotic stress. Firstly, biofertilizer can do a modification of hormonal balance. AMF can increase the production of essential isoprenoids instead of non-essential isoprenoid. This is because of increasing of carotenoids derivative biosynthesis such as abscisic acid, or also known as ABA, strycholactones, and jasmonic acid, also known as JA, in mycorrhizal plants. Mycorrhizal plants can increase the transpiration rate and water absorption by roots. AMF also can enhance the conductance of stomatal, rate of transpiration, and conductivity of hydrolyte during drought stress. These improvements can indicate the enhancement of plant water status and uptaking, as well as transporting of water in host plants. Plants which can naturally infected by AMF have better and better osmotic adjustment compared to the non-infected one. Plants which associate with AMF facing minimum oxidative damage under drought stress. Besides, AMF also can facilitate better nutrients supply to host. Last but not least, AMF can enhance rate of photosynthesis of plants, increasing productivity of stomata. AMF is one of the biotechnology application in agriculture which successfully maintain the crop productivity even though in drought stress. In agriculture, drought is an obstacle due to climate change which can disturb economic growth in many countries. AMF is one of the successful biotechnology application in agriculture that can solve the issues arose. However, research should be planned on the effect of AMF synergistic towards rhizobacteria and endophytes. Rhizobacteria and endophytes growth are promoted by plant growth, which can cause stress, since research have been found that EMF can maintain osmosis regulation of plant. Research should be conducted on osmolized gene coding. This research should investigate the interaction between EMF and roots of host for higher plants. Then, plant genotypes and EMF species are different types which can cause dissymbiosis of EMF and plants also varies. So, research should investigate on which species can cope better with drought stress. Last but not least, research should be conducted to find out the signaling mechanism and synthesis of brassicosteroid and salicylic acid in EMF during drought stress. Thank you for watching our video. Take care of yourself and see you soon in future.